Sets, a web series highlighting the many successes of our alumni. What you're hearing in the background is the music of today's guest, artist, actor, and musician, Nickolai Salcedo. Nickolai.
Yes.
Thank you for coming on today's show.
Yeah, man.
Okay, I remember you in Form 1. The image I have of you, and I have a picture to show the audience, is of you with this really big bag on your back and a sketch pad in your hand walking around the school.
That was me.
That was you?
Yeah.
Okay, what were your years in Nickolai like?
To be quite honest, it was hell. I did not enjoy it really. But then I've never enjoyed school at all.
Okay.
But that's just me. I'm pretty much of a loner. So being around people just always makes me uncomfortable.
Mm.
Which is funny that now I'm a performer.
Right.
I'm always around people. But yeah, in a way the thing that for me school was, it pretty much was just me coming to this place and, you know, just really trying to learn how to interact.
Mm.
You know, and yeah. I had a couple of friends, literally a couple of friends, and you know, that was like me. They also did art, you know, so that was how I kind of started to get propelled into that field.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, I was always into art, but then I had friends who were into it as well.
Right.
And yeah, I mean, I was like the smallest guy,
right.
You know, so I used to get picked on all the time.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm beaten. Time.
Being in school?
Yeah, man.
Really?
Yeah!
Yeah.
But the good thing was, what it did, it literally just made me feel angry a lot of the time. And, like, because I couldn't really express that anger in any particular sort of way, what I ended up doing is just trying to put it out artistically.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I kept that. I just kept that. And it also made me look at things, made me look at the injustices that people deal out to each other in society, in the small scale of a school, in the wider scale of the country, in everything. And I was always like that. Even when I was in school, I was always drawing those kinds of links and everything. So my friends were always like, dude, you're way too heavy. Like, even now people are always like, you're too serious.
Okay.
You know, you need to lighten up and all that. But it's just because I'm like, hey, I just, you know, I see things.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that's what I write about, and that's what I do.
Okay. Okay, Nickolai, you said that you found solace in your art when these kids were being mean to you. Did you then dream of becoming an artist?
No. No. I wasn't thinking about being an artist. I think the first time that I ever considered being an artist as a thing is when I saw the movie Great Expectations with Ethan Hawke, which was somewhere like mid-90s, I think, or something like that. And yeah, because he was an artist in it and all those sorts of things, and then I was like, hey, that's an idea. Let's paint and go to Paris. But back in school, I wasn't really thinking necessarily about being an artist. I just felt as though this is where I get to be away from people.
Mm-hmm.
The art room. So a lot of times I'm afraid to say.
Well, you cut classes?
Yes, yeah, so I skipped classes. Okay? I skipped classes. And just hung out in the art room a lot. And Miss Velasquez used to have to be like, Nickolai, you know, she used to put off your foot long a few times. But then she knew as well when a lot of this stuff was going on. You know, but it was more or less just a place to get away from everybody, you know. Because I never really took to the noise too much.
Mm.
And I mean, a school is a lot of noise,
right.
As you would know. And I just never really took to it. And I never was into sports and all the wild playing and everything. Which made everybody feel like, what is this problem? Come and play something, you know? And I would be like, dude, I don't want to play. I want to draw. I want my mind to be expanding right now and taking new worlds, you know? And so I didn't really think about being an artist. At that time, it was about Form 6 probably when I actually was like, hey, let's be an artist.
Mm.
Or right about Form 5 probably, and that's when I decided, okay, well, we'll do it for Form 6.
Mm.
Yeah.
Nickolai, tell me about your band, Kiasek. Where did And when did you start performing?
Yazet's first performance was in 2007, September. Mm. Where did the idea come from? I woke up one morning in 2006 and started writing songs at the rate of like one a day. So I literally just spent like a couple of months just writing. And then I met up with a guy named Ruba Holder, who's also a grad student of Riverside. Mm-hmm. And we were like, hey, what's up, man? Catching up and everything. And he was like, what do you need to know? I was like, I'm a songwriter, man. I'm writing, and I play guitar. And he was like, really? I play guitar too. And then I found out he lives right around the corner from me. So I was like, well, dude, come and check me. Let's jam a little bit. And yeah, he came through, he jammed, he was like, yeah, it sounds good, you know. And then we put in a drummer, Ruba was on bass, me on guitar, and we started jamming officially. Then we had to find a name for the band because we were like, well, we're going to go and play somewhere. We want to go to an open mic, and we'll open this year. And we were doing Julian Moore's Songshine. So what ended up happening is, we couldn't think of a name because we were trying to find a name that could resonate with Trinidad, and you know, we felt Kalu and a bunch of other names that just seemed too cliche. So I was like, alright, dude, I opened a dictionary and I just flicked the pages like that. He stuck his finger in, landed on Gaza Strip. And I was like, nah, we can't use Gaza Strip, you know. Started to go down the line, and then we saw Gazette. And I was like, hey, Gazette.
Right.
You know, and he as well immediately responded. And so that, from there the name stuck with us. Then we went to Julian Moore's show and she announced us and the name stuck with the crowd.
Yeah. Why was band notorious?
Well, I think when Gazette emerged onto the scene, or rather when we landed on the scene, you know, it was at a time when the local underground music scene, I think, had reached, not stalemate, but things got kind of, you know, settled. And we came with a really fresh new song, you know, because we were pushing like a mixture of Kaiso and rock, and you know, that emanated from my style of playing guitar, because I'm self-taught. Okay. So therefore, all the musicians would look at me and be like, dude, you have very poor technique.
Okay.
Yeah, they were telling me, like a couple of them were like, your technique is horrible, but it sounds excellent, you know? Because to them, they're like, how do you make that song? Because we can't. And we're like technically proficient. And I think because of that, it literally made us get a certain limelight. Added to which, the songs that I was writing, the things I was writing about, which was basically all of that pent up anger from school years. Right. Now coming up, you know, so yeah, it was a lot of angry stuff and a lot of very bold stuff, you know. I was just saying things that I felt like, well, look, I can feel free to say it here, I can't say it when I get off the stage. So while I'm on the stage, you know, I'm gonna just say whatever I have to say, you know. And as a result, basically it gained us some notoriety because the performance style of the band as well is very much like a full-fledged rock show, you know.
Nickolai, I've seen you on stage, I've seen you in film. Was this a natural progression for you? Or is it something that, hey, this has come along, the opportunity has come along, I might as well try it?
Natural progression.
Okay.
Because I've always been interested in acting, I guess. Not as interested as I am now, you know, but I've always been into, you know, it's just performing, you know. So after performing with Gazette on stage, and that was high level performance, and then I just felt like, well, okay, and everyone would just play Nickolai, you belong on a stage, man. Right? I'm like, hey. A play opened up, and I was like, I'm gonna try out for it, you know. Then try more auditions, audition. Keep trying to get parts, you know, to make sure that I keep whetting my appetite with that, just making sure that, you know, getting my foot in that door. And yeah, it just progressed to that point. It just reached the point where I was like, yeah, well, I like this as well. You know, acting on stage, I like that. Mm-hmm. And then I tried out for film, the first time I did, I was like, I didn't like it. You know, mm-hmm. It's kind of weird.
Was this for Pan?
No, oh. This was for a student film.
Okay.
A few years ago. Yeah, I tried that out and I was like, I'm not too sure. This is back when I had like locks,
right,
and grass and everything. I was like, I don't really like it, you know, it's kind of weird. But let's try it out again at some mm-hmm. point. So when Pan opened up, I was like, all right, I'm going to try that. And by that time, I had done a bit more plays and, mm-hmm. you know, so I tried out for Pan, and yeah.
Okay, so now you're solo.
Yes.
Okay.
I flew out of the country earlier this year to go and act in a film about Albert Cross. Went to London for a month and a half, and then Ghana for a month and a half. And it was a life-changing experience. And it just made me realize that while out there, I felt as though I had a few epiphanies about a lot of things about my personal life, and I realized that, you know what, I don't want to just be a musician, or just a visual artist, or just an actor. I want to be all these things together, and I want to be pushing it as one solid product. And this is who I am, Nickolai Salcedo, I'm an artist. Bam, you know? Rather than pushing Nickolai Salcedo and pushing Gazette, mm-hmm. you know, pushing it separate entities. I was like, no, it's one entity. It's one product, one brand, you know? So I went out there, and during that experience, I literally felt like, man, I remember there was a night I was talking to other people from the club. And we sat there and I was like, dude, I think when I go back home, I'm going to go solo, you know? Because you have to remember too, it literally frees me up now as an artist to do whatever I want to do.
Right.
You know, so for instance, the new music I've been working on is, it's pretty much like, all right, I can mix whatever I want to mix with, you know? I could go that way, I could go that way. Whereas before, Gazette was like, yeah, we were very much a very mixing kind of music. But at the same time, I guess for me, as a songwriter, yeah, I wrote the songs. Mm-hmm. But it was my band, basically. Mm-hmm. But it came from me, right? It was all about band. But as a songwriter, I knew in my head what I wanted to hear. Mm-hmm. But because it's a band, it's a kind of a collaborative effort, you know, it never ever came out how I wanted to hear it. Mm-hmm. So therefore, I always felt like I'm not grooving this the right way. I don't feel this, you know? Whereas now I'm like, well then, okay, I'm going to do it my way.
You know, so I'm just wondering, what advice would you give to young people who might want to pursue the creative arts?
Be yourself. Be yourself. And the reason why I say that is, as an artist, that's all you have. It's you, you know? Be yourself and be very, very smart about what you're doing, who you associate with, you know? Be wise as a serpent and harmless as a dove. You know, people abuse artists business-wise,
mm-hmm.
because of the fact they know that as an artist, you do it for the love of it.
Mm-hmm.
You would do it for the love of it. I mean, you're also doing it to make a living, but you would gladly do it for the love of it.
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of people could take advantage of that if you don't have your wits about you, you know? So what I would say to a young person is you need to be solidly rooted and grounded in you. So if you want to be an artist, you need to spend some time with you, you know? I mean, like, for instance, for me, I've had to break up relationships, I've had to give up on a lot of things You know, give up on your comforts. And I think if you want to be an artist, you have to just literally say, you know, comforts are something that you know you work towards. It's not something that you hold on to.
Mm-hmm. Nickolai, it's really good chatting with you.
Yes.
Thanks for being here.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Nickolai Salcedo, and the name of the song is Small Fry.
Small fry. I'm in the cold tonight.